Hey everybody, it's PartyElite. Welcome back to our tour of Warhammer 3 Immortal Empires Let's Play, where we're playing as Karl Franz, and where things might seem just a little strange right now. You might be wondering, hey, wait a second, Party, this isn't the state Erengrad was left in at the end of the previous session, and you would be right. It seems chaos works in mysterious ways always, and perhaps Tzeentch himself was somehow involved in this plot, but folks, unfortunately, the latest save file for this campaign, for some unknown reason, refuses to load. Every time I try to load in, it just crashes to the desktop. I've tried reinstalling the game, I've verified the game files, I've installed it on a different drive, I've tried everything, and it just refuses, absolutely refuses to load that latest save. Fortunately, by Sigmar's blessings, I suppose, we do have the autosave that was saved right after Ubel lost against Clan Mulder, but just before the little switcheroo happened, the switcheroo between Thrott and Archaon besieging Erengrad, the switcheroo that perhaps was the one thing that was going to allow Ubel to live for just a little bit longer. So just to realign your mind and my mind with regards to what the current circumstances actually are compared to what they were at the end of the previous session, and again, what are you going to do, right? We're going to take it in stride, and we're going to move forward, it'll be fine, whatever happens will happen, it'll be okay. But just to again, realign our minds, Ubel is still at Erengrad, he is still suffering from attrition, he is still unable to recruit those units we were trying to recruit, because Thrott the Unclean is still the one who has Erengrad under siege. Now, when we hit the end turn button, hopefully we'll see that switcheroo happen again. I am tempted to sally forth with Ubel to try and defeat Thrott's army. I think I mentioned this last session, but it was after the fact, or maybe I just thought about it after the session was done and I didn't say it out loud, but I think if I send Ubel out right now, I might be able to defeat Thrott's army, but that's not what we did last time, so it's not what I'm going to do this time. I don't like when things like this happen because of bugs or crashes or whatever it might be. I don't like changing my own decisions. The AI might change what they decide to do, but I don't like changing what I decide to do because it almost feels cheesy at that point. At that point, it starts feeling like save scumming, so I try to avoid that as best as possible, as logically as possible. So Ubel is going to stay at Erengrad, and we're simply going to pray that that switch happens, and that buys us enough time to actually get the reinforcements from Ulrich Strom here to arrive. Again, it's not one turn, it's two turns it'll take for Ulrich to get here, because that red mark is not close enough. That is not reinforcement range from Erengrad. We have to be a little bit closer. So it's two turns before he'll get up there and hopefully save Ubel. As opposed to save whoever replaces Ubel. And apart from that, down over here, we do have Karl still pushing in towards Fallen King Mountain. He's going to push in next turn. We know that Azag is somewhere down here about to strike at Zufbar, but again, I'm not going to act on that knowledge. We'll let it play out. We're going to try and get Grom Peak and then move towards Zufbar and future me speaking. Now we'll move towards Zufbar to try and protect it, leaving our rear a little open, unfortunately. I do think Glugzag Edbutt, is going to take Khazad Irkalaz with very little pushback, unfortunately. But it is what it is. We'll have to figure something out in terms of how to respond to this situation. Now, some of you were suggesting that perhaps we get Gelt on the offensive, and that's probably a good idea, actually. Right now, Gelt is recruiting the last couple of units of Knights of the Blazing Sun. My initial intent was to keep him down here alongside Nicholas, who's on a bit of an adventure of his own. We'll touch on that in a moment. But my plan was to keep him down here in case one of these fools decides to declare war upon us. But honestly, the current circumstances, as we know them to be next turn, might force our hand in sending Gelt over this way to actually help with the situation over here, because it's getting a little pressing, I think. And I'll explain why when we actually get to the next turn. Meanwhile, over here, Nicholas is still recruiting the two units of Halberdiers. We're still leaving a gap for that third unit of greatswords, the Karabur greatswords, but we'll only get them when it's time to actually engage, right? We don't need them right now, but he's headed up towards Arnau the next couple of turns will be done up over here, I think, and we'll be able to bring Nicholas back down south. I think that's all the recapping we need. The only reason I'm going so heavy on it is because the weirdness of, you know, going back by a whole turn and it being a little different from just where things ended it also helps me kind of realign myself, as I was saying. But folks, let's go ahead and I think hit the end turn button. We're not going to repair anything over here because it's in trouble. Let's be real here. They're probably going to take Khazad Irkalaz. I would love to be able to defeat this army, but that's highly unlikely. We'll see what comes of it, folks. Let's go ahead and pan our camera up over here to Erengrad, where the serious threats lie. And let's simply pray that the same moves are made by the AI as were made previously. Folks, fingers crossed, because I still haven't lost any love for this campaign. There's no love lost despite this little hiccup, and I hope you haven't lost love for the campaign because of this hiccup either. Again, we can make some explanation in our headcanon. It's a premonition sent to us or whatever it might be. But either way, folks, if you are enjoying this series, if you would like to see it continue, please don't hesitate to keep letting me know by leaving those likes and comments down below. They make a very big difference in just letting me know what people are interested in watching on the channel, letting me know what I should do more or less of, or how I should adjust the content on the channel accordingly. So if you want to see this continue to conclusion, leave those likes, leave those comments, and it looks like the AI has left its plans intact as they were previously. We've got a little switcheroo going down. Archaeons put Erengrad under siege. Meanwhile, Wolfric is back declaring war as well, so things are looking pretty intact, which feels pretty good. I'm glad, because it's always a bit of a bummer whenever this happens. It's always a bit of a bummer when it changes outcomes. You know, like, it's not just total war. Like, it happened a lot in Bannerlord as well when I was playing Bannerlord in its super early access stages, right? Like, the game would crash sometimes, it would just break, this, that, and the other thing, and I would go back by so much of time or distance, and I would have to rely on the AI actually doing the same things. Here, at least, because it's turn-based and a little pre-calculated, I suppose, it's a bit more likely that the AI does the same stuff, but then events change, right? Like, I don't remember this event. Maybe it was there. Maybe I'm forgetting. Either way, on your advice and the promise of financial returns, Boris Todbringer of Midland had joined you in what appeared to be a surefire investment. Oh, we've read this event before. I'm not going to read it again. I obviously do not want to lose the fealty of Midland, so we will go ahead and arrange political favors. Use some of our prestige over here. We have plenty on hand. And as you can see, the switch did happen down over here. And it looks like Khazad Irkalaz has been put under siege as well as, yes, Erengrad, as we can see here. And the wild hunt ceases. Yes, excellent. Ceases? Not sure. Barded Warhorse for Rupert Wolf. Good for you, buddy. Up over here, what are we looking at? So, Ubel did not die. wasn't going to in one turn anyway, but now he's just bought himself a little bit more time, it feels like, to survive over here as we'd hoped. So let's go ahead and get Ulrich as far up as we can get him, right? As far up as we can get him, and then it's not reinforcing range, is it? It is not. We just gotta hope that they don't strike next turn. We'll see. So that's that taken care of for the time being. Actually, hang on a second, who do we have here? Rupert Wolf, you just leveled up. Can we can assault you 12% chance of success. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go ahead and, yes, get specialist, get that extra 1% and see what it does for us. And let's go ahead and strike at Archaon over here. Go ahead and assault the units with that 13% chance of success. Come on, baby. Ah, okay. No surprise. It's okay. It was worth a shot, worth the investment, a little bit of gold. We could also perhaps block the army, because we have Udolf down over here, right? I don't think there's any value in doing that necessarily. Oh, in fact, we can't. Oh, right, because we're exhausted. No, we're not. We're just simply incapable of it, really? Wow, okay, fair enough, so be it. Stay there, I suppose. I could instead, hit this guy, Valgar Ovesen. Spreading his chaos, undivided corruption. Sure, go for the assassination here. 39% chance of success. Even if we fail, we still gain some XP, right? So there's a silver lining to that. Either way, it is what it is. Hopefully this works out. Meanwhile, down over here, where are we? I always lose myself in the mountains. Down over here, we're finally able to move into the Fallen King Mountain. I believe, yes, decisive victory. Casualties low. We'll go ahead and auto-resolve this. Yeah. No need to fight it. Good stuff. Cool. Occupy it as well. Not going to loot and occupy. Simply occupy. We'll try and hold on to it for as long as possible. I doubt we'll be able to. I'm pretty sure these guys are going to go rampaging through, unless I can somehow magically stop them at Khazad Irkalaz. They're going to go rampaging through and take Nashrek Slayer and Fallen King Mountain, while Karl heads down over here to take Grom Peak and then push into Azag, who will hopefully be held back by Zufbar and its walls and his needs to, you know, like, build siege towers and stuff like that. I don't know. Fingers crossed. We're hopeful. Carl, you've leveled up. Let's go ahead and get you Foe Seeker, I suppose. It's become really fuzzy to me now. It's like, did we already do these last session or did we not? I can't remember. It is what it is, though, because we must have, because, yeah, it was after I took Fallen King Mountain, I noticed they had Grom Peak, and then I noticed Azag, right? That's what happened, right? Anyway, it's all a blur. It's irrelevant. It was a premonition. They weren't real events. That's why it's so fuzzy. Balthazar Gelt, we're going to actually, yes, pull him back, I think. Like I said, in the comments, it was suggested we put him on the front foot, get him being aggressive, and perhaps coming towards Zufbar is not a terrible idea. It'll take Carl how long? It'll take Carl... Ready. If I just march over to... can I see? It'll not... Yeah, it will. Let me see. So it'll take us 3 turns to get here, right? 1, 2, 3 turns to get here, plus attacking Grom Peak. We will not need to wait to build siege towers or anything, so that's just one more turn. So 1, 2... it looks like 1, 2, 3, 4... Maybe even 5, I don't know, we'll see. Okay, so 5 turns versus Gelt, if we get you in forced march, and we try to move you up to here, it'll take you, that looks like also 5 turns, right? Because we have, what are we looking at? 1, 2, 3, 4 turns. 4 or 5, give or take. Sure, let's go ahead and bring you up this way as well. And a worst case scenario, yeah, sure, one of these guys will declare war and Gelt will have to quickly turn around. Ideally, I guess, we'll have Nicholas done his business up north and then he'll be able to come down south a bit more quickly, right, because he'll be closer for sure. We went, I believe, all the way past Gorsel to as far as we could go to strike at Arnau. Again, not in a rush to recruit that 20th unit, and now that I've actually seen what we're up against, I think I'm even less convinced that I need that 20th unit just quite yet. Again, just saving on some upkeep costs when we can, right? No real reason beyond that. And actually, at Altdorf, we do now have the option to build the Gunsmith. Where are we? Gunsmith. Where'd you go, buddy? Gunsmith, there we go. Because this goes up to level 5, right, for the steam tanks and stuff. So sure, Gunsmith will give us access to handgunners and war wagons as well, but it's the handgunners that we wanted for Gelt's army, right? By the way, it was pointed out in the comments as well that, and I agree, I think you're very much right, that, I think it was that in when you go to demolish a building, you're supposed to get money back. It's supposed to refund you, not cost you money. And I agree, in Warhammer 2 and 1, it was that. However, the UI here literally says this will cost 1,200 gold. So I'm going to trust the UI. What I'm going to do actually is between this session and next session when I go to record it, I'll actually test this out. But I'm going to trust the UI when I'm actually playing that it'll cost me 1,200. And if this is wrong, well, that's on CA. I mean, again, it's a strategy game. It's kind of important for the tooltips to tell me what's actually going to happen when I click a button. Hopefully this is accurate, and in which case, cool, they've just changed how it works. And I don't mind the new approach. If it is supposed to be expensive, I don't mind that at all. Now, what are we doing? We're done up over here. We're done everything. We're done everything here. Heroes not moved. That's Albrecht Strom. But yeah, sorry, I wanted to address that just because I saw it mentioned in the comments. And I was thinking the same thing as well. Every time I hovered over the demolish building option, I was like, oh, weird that they changed that. But fair enough, they changed that. And we don't have the money to waste on demolishing a building that doesn't desperately need demolishing. But then it was pointed out in the comments. It's like, I'm pretty sure it works the other way around. And I was like, I thought so too. But the words say otherwise in the game. Anyway, that's this turn's organization stuff done. Let's see how Archaon responds to this evolving situation. This is a scary army. We'll see. Let's go ahead and hit the end turn button and hope for the best here. Really nervous about this. Really nervous about the situation here overall. I mean, this is a hot zone. Like, this is like a flashpoint, right? We got all of our enemies up over here, including a new one now as well with Wulfric, right? And we could actually see, there's actually a couple of things we could see with regards to our allies. Because with Kislev, we might be able to... Don't you dare declare... Okay, thank God. I was like, are you for real? We barely moved Gelt out of the region. He's not even out of the region because these guys are like over here, right? Yeah, like they're located further down over here, but they confederated with the folks that declared war on us and then immediately got confederated, right? Sure, yeah, I mean, I'll counter off for this. I was so worried for a second that immediately we're going to have a war declared upon us. Looks like they can't afford anything more than 100 gold. Fine, I'll accept. Let it be. What was I saying? Right, so I could perhaps take a look at working with Kislev a bit more. because we have the defensive alliance now, if I recall correctly. Oh, wait, hang on a second. Oh, cheeky, cheeky, cheeky. Very cheeky. You know, I don't think I expressed well enough just how much I like, how much I've enjoyed being done in like this by Azag's moves and the Bone Rattlers being clever. Like, every once in a while in Total War, the AI really pulls something clever off, and you can't help but appreciate it. I thought I was pushing these guys on the back foot. Little did I know that they were actually moving forwards in the other direction. Like, my goodness. And now here we are. They're about to take Oakenhammer. Oh, this is not good. We're going to auto-resolve this. We've lost a couple turns of time here then. Yeah, auto-resolve this. Decisive defeat. Casualties high. There's no chance here. Oh, this is trouble. This is trouble. This is trouble. Please don't take it. They're going to take it. Why would they not take it? Please don't take it. God damn it, they took it. And what's this now? Khazid Irkalaz as well. Oh my goodness, I think I have to... Oh my goodness, I think I have to try and fight this one, folks. We stand like no chance. They're going to absolutely crush us. They're going to absolutely crush us, but we have to try and cause at least some damage to maybe make them hesitate about what they're going to do next. We have a couple of guns. We have some crossbows. Oh boy. You know what, folks? I think we're going to have to try this. And y'all let me know what you think about these kinds of battles as well, where we're like guaranteed to lose, but if we get lucky, we're able to maybe kill a couple of units and just reduce the momentum on our enemy's side. Like, let me know what you feel about these types of battles, because sometimes they can make a very big difference, and sometimes I understand they can be rather pointless to watch. But for now, I'll be making the call, and the call is to the battlefield we go. Alright, folks, let's see what we can do. Initially, I wasn't going to fight this battle. Initially, I was just like, yeah, whatever, they can take it. It's fine, we'll come back. How did you build four of these in one turn? Oh. Okay, this is going to be a lot rougher than I'd initially anticipated. Oh, no. Oh, no. And we only have 500 supplies. Oh, we're in so much trouble. Yeah, so initially I wasn't actually going to fight this battle at all. It's like, yeah, okay, whatever, take it. There's nothing we can do here. But now with Azag having taken Oakenhammer, things are a little different, and I need to stem the bleeding as much as possible for the time being. Let's get our swords up over here as well. Just gonna try and hold the line for as long as possible up here. I'm kind of tempted to let them through so that our towers back here can get some more work done. But at the same time, like, what's one piercing tower going to do compared to some of these towers up front, right? Well, don't get me wrong, we'll build the piercing tower for sure, and it'll help us as much as it can. But let's go ahead and make sure we actually claim these towers as well with our guns and crossbows. This was a terrible idea. I shouldn't have gone in for this. I shouldn't have fought this battle. What are these guys doing over here? Great swords. Let's push you up over here. They can move in afterwards. My hope is that we're able to fire down at some of these chariots and stuff as they come up, perhaps. Let's get the handgunners up over here. They can maybe fire down at, the Spider Rider archers or Goblin Wolf chariots. Whatever they can fire at, they'll fire at, while we have these towers as well to do as much damage as possible. Okay, no point spending any more time planning or anything like that. There is... God damn it. A couple units behind us as well. What are these? Are you for real? Where did you? How did they? Am I losing my mind here? What am I not understanding? How did they get these battering rams and four siege towers with only one turn at siege? Anyway, it is what it is. That honestly, that changes the situation entirely. Let's begin. The reason why I say that changes the situation entirely is because where I thought they'd be using the ladders, getting exhausted, we'd have more time, this, that, and the other thing, where I thought all that was possible, well, I mean, it's not, is it? It's not. I mean, initial shots coming in from these towers, though, doing a fair bit of work. Gunfire coming through as well, hopefully causing some damage to these Forest Goblin Spider Rider archers. Yeah, looking okay. More tower fire coming through, getting a little bit of work done. I don't think firing at their siege towers is going to make much of a difference, but there's not much else we can fire at, really. Try hitting some of these goblin archers, I suppose. Or, didn't do anything there. Still firing away these forest goblin spider rider archers. So many words for one unit. Getting some work done, hopefully. The towers here. Let's hit the orc boar boys, I suppose. You can keep hitting the goblin wolf chariot. Alright, we'll see what we can do. Come on now. Come on now, get some work done over here. At least the gunfire is doing something. We might actually be able to eliminate this unit of forest, goblin, spider, rider, archers, maybe. And I mean, we're doing some damage to some of these towers, but that's not going to make a real difference. This guy's too far back, isn't he? Maybe we can hit something up over there. I've got enough points for another tower. I just wonder if it's worth actually building. Or if I should save up for something a bit more advanced. At least we're getting rid of these guys. Here they come. Oh boy. Some of them are using ladders. Some goblin archers are using ladders, it seems like. But otherwise, it's all these towers lining up, getting ready to drop their troops off. Again, some night goblin archers up over here, and orc biggins. Those are the scary ones. The orc biggins are the scary ones. Send you in. We've got our great swords over here. Let's bring these guys over this way to help against some of these biggins over here. Still firing away. Still doing an okay job, actually. We're about to eliminate two units. So, and getting some damage done to these orc boar boys as well. So, as much as we're guaranteed to lose this battle as these orcs pour out from their towers, as much as that's guaranteed to happen, at least we've caused some damage. And we can take some solace in that. That's the intent with these, with fighting these kinds of battles, right? Like, I know I'm going to lose. I know I'm going to lose, but can I get some work done at the same time? And down over here, like Buddy over here is getting some shots in. I'm going to save up for the upgrade to the cannon tower, I think. 1150 is all we need. That might actually get some work done. Gunfire on these orc boar boys as they try to hit the gates, I think. And up over here, the fighting has begun. Let's just try and apply a bit of pressure. Nope, don't go outside. Apply a bit of pressure there. And if I can turn the guns around eventually, we'll be in a better place. These guys are not able to fire these orc boar boys as well. Let's go ahead and try and eliminate them. Oh, how did these guys get through? Did they just pour through? For real? That's hilarious. Fire away at these guys. Fire away at these guys. Let's go ahead. Get you firing away down over here. And we can upgrade you, perhaps. No, we're not 1150 yet. Numbers. All right, these orc boar boys are maybe pulling back. Got a couple of shatters over here. Hopefully they're dead, but the orc boar boys taking some damage over here. Good work by the cannon towers as well. We've lost this tower over here. No surprise there. Let's send the halberds in. Let's send these halberds in as well. Just got to bolster our numbers a bit, right? Add a bit of meat to our side of it all. Still firing away. Yeah. Good stuff here. Get you firing up over there. Yeah, these guys are still shooting down over here. Good stuff. Go ahead and upgrade this tower, please. I was a little slow on the draw there. 30 seconds it'll take to actually build it. Hopefully these guys aren't able to get too much done in the meantime. Lost vision for the time being. We're okay, though. These guys have given up. We're being completely overrun over here. But it's okay. It's okay. You know what? I'm actually genuinely quite pleased with our output in this battle. We have actually caused more damage than I was expecting to cause. Much more. We got this piercing tower done over here as well, firing away at the orc biggins up there. 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds until this guy is done, and then hopefully we can get some more shots up over here. They're nicely clumped up, so we might actually be able to get some work done firing at our own walls from the inside. Do what we can. These orc boar boys have taken a lot of damage. They're basically done for. There's 9 of them left. They've given up on the fight between the crossbows and the handguns and the tower fire. Look at that, completely shattered. 3 of them left. 2 of them left, even. Good stuff. Now the question is, can we turn all of our guns and stuff around to fire away at these like orc biggins and stuff? Can we get rid of another unit of biggins or something over here as the piercing tower fires away and as the cannon tower fires away as well? Is that going to make any contact? Are we seeing any difference being made over here? I don't know, but the guns are shooting. They have turned around. They are opening fire. Crossbows coming through as well. Come on, hold the line, halberds. Hold the line. Oh, the cannon tower is just barely missing, eh? It's like just whiffing those shots. Come on, keep at it, keep at it. There's such big clumps over here. This is good, though. I mean, ooh. Hit our tower there. Albert's holding the line. These swords. Get in there. Keep firing. Don't forget, there's a whole other contingent coming in from right behind us, right? Oh, come on, cannon tower. I believe in you. Oh, that actually, I think that did some work. I wonder if we should, here we go. The goblin archers are up over here. These handgunners, we could turn around and fire at these orc boar boys instead of the clump over here. I just don't know who's worth firing on more, you know? Maybe let's hit some of these orc boar boys. Damn, these night goblin archers are now firing at us finally. Fire away these orc boar boys, please. Come on, try and eliminate them. Cannon tower is still getting some work done. Ah, man, we're like just barely missing, it feels like. They're not able to get clean hits in. They're not causing too much damage, but we seem to be causing a decent bit of damage. Yeah, in comes another shot from the cannon tower. It keeps hitting their siege tower, eh? I mean, look, these Orc Boar Boys have taken a fair bit of damage. That's not bad. Maybe fire down at these Night Goblin Archers next. I don't think these guys are done for. Ah, we're done for. That's unfortunate. A valiant defeat, but you know what? Like I said, I'll take it. We actually caused a fair bit of damage there. Let's see how much of it sticks, and let's see how much of it makes an actual difference. Because I doubt we did enough damage to stop them in their tracks or to even force them to pull back. But I mean, look, we eliminated one entire unit. We caused a fair bit of damage to one more unit. I guess these guys got away before we were able to cause a significant amount of damage. These guys might merge. I mean, this army might get a little bit smaller at least. I don't know if it was really worth it. We killed about 400 troops, twice as many as they killed. About the same as they actually killed, considering this entire garrison's gone. So you know what? You know what? Pound for pound, we put out a pretty good pounding, I guess. I don't think this will make enough of a difference. I wonder if I could have made some slightly different decisions to make a bigger difference, but not really sure what, you know? Just because of how they were deployed. But I'll take it. You know what? Yeah, look at that. Completely wiped this unit. These guys are basically worthless now. These guys are at half strength. These guys have got to merge. They'll have one at half strength. These guys are... Yeah, I mean, they'll spend some time recruiting, but that means they're not moving, right? If they're recruiting, they're not moving. And that's good. Valiant defeat. I will take it gladly. But now, as the turn cycle ends... Oh, actually... Ooh. Okay, on? Where'd you go, buddy? No clue yet, but... When the turn cycle ends, I'll explain in greater detail why this Oakenhammer situation is that much worse for us than Zufbar. I mean, I already touched on the, I think, relatively obvious, which is, Yard Boys and the Slaves of Tsar have grouped up, confederated. Oakenhammer has been, yes, looted, not just looted, but it's actually been taken as well. And the reason why this is such a big problem, folks, I keep getting interrupted by good news. Mousillon, well, bad news too, I guess. Mousillon has been destroyed, so I guess the Bretonians finally made a move there. Good for them. You're not an actual ambusher against us. Okay, so, here's the thing. Yes, this sucks, because now Azag is able to keep moving. He's not stuck, you know, besieging Zufbar or anything like that. But this also sucks, because now, from Oakenhammer, Schwarzhaven is two turns away. As opposed to from Zufbar, where Schwarzhaven might have been maybe three turns away, give or take. Maybe, you know, close-ish. Maybe force march in a turn. Anyway, he's that much closer to being able to hit, like, some of these core territories, which I do not like. He might go after Carrick Dromar instead, just because of his attraction to the climate and stuff like that, which is better for us. But either way, I mean, I'm glad Gelt is making his way over, I suppose. I'm glad that we're trying to be aggressive from both sides over here. Because this way, what we can do is we can send Gelt this way, right? It'll take him three turns to get here. It'll take him two turns to get to Schwarzhaven. So if they do come towards Schwarzhaven, we can take it back more quickly. We won't be there in time to defend it, I don't think, but we can take it back more quickly. Oh, that's so much money wasted. I don't think we invested in these because the Golden Order did, but, you know, their money has been wasted. I'm glad I didn't invest any of my own, but I'm going to have to waste it now moving forward. Okay, so hang on a second. If Gelt is coming from that side, should Karl Franz pull back this way? Because why sandwich Azag over here, take Grom Peak, take Oakenhammer, and just simply allow these guys to waltz through? I think Karl should pull back in the other direction. So, let's move up to here as far as you can go. Still keep replenishing as much as you can. And let's try and take Glugzag Edbud. Of course, he's able to replenish very quickly. But he's a 13 stack now, as opposed to what he was before, so some solace. Trying to see the silver lining. Anyway, the bigger deal is up over here, though. Erengrad, what's the situation? Okay, Archaon has decided to give up his siege. Oh my. I forgot about Azazel. As depraved as I. Jesus, man. What in God's name? Got another near full stack up over here, 15. We got Wolfric coming through with his 18 stack. All right, hang on. On the topic of Wolfric. Kislev, buddy. Yes, let us. They're so weak. They're so weak. I can't request an army. I can't set a target until next turn. Do I bother building an outpost? It'll probably get crushed within a couple turns of it being built, if it's even allowed to get built. All right, let's leave it be. Oh, this is what I was thinking. I was like, oh, maybe we get an outpost built. Maybe we tell them to go after Wolfric. But I don't think that's going to happen. I don't think they have much time left. It looks like they are being a little aggressive, at least against what? The Bear Sonlings over here, and is this Wintertooth? Yeah. I guess those are the closer threats to them. Fair enough. They're doing what's logical. Damn it. Alright, this is a situation, isn't it? Ubul now is in a good position, though, because he was allowed to get the full replenishment from the previous turn, because Archaon gave up before the turn cycle ended, so the mere threat of Ulrich straw-armed Archaon away, I suppose, but now I'm...
Do not frustrate me.
Do I hit Azazel? Or do I hit Archaon? We can actually wipe Archaon out, I think, right? Yes, now, the thing is... We will have reinforcements when we engage him here, but he'll probably retreat, and so we'll chase after him to finish him off. Do we send Ubul in, or do we send Ulrich in? Let's send Ulrich in. Let's go for it. I think it makes more sense. Ubul stays in here, tries to replenish. We got all the recruitment and stuff done as well, so that's good. But yeah, Ulrich, let's go. And you're going to, predictably, yes, retreat. Not surprised there. That's the logical move. He's retreated a bit farther than I expected. I think we should be able to hit that and then come back. Dealing with Azazel is always scary because, like, seduction and stuff as well, right? Not sure how much he can exactly twist in his favor. But we do also have, like, the Mad Bombardiers and the Descending Suns in Ulrich's army, so there's that. Against all these Marauders, that should be quite valuable. A little worried about the Seeker Chariots. Chaos Chariots there. Okay, you know what, here. Ulrich, let's chase after Archaon. Balance power seems slightly in our favor. Might be a bad idea. Close victory, casualties low. Close victory. I just wonder if I should dive in here or not. He's got that hell cannon, which worries me. Oh, you know what I should have done is I should have tried to assault units first. That's what I should have done. 13% chance of success. That's not really worth it, I don't think. All right, I think we'll dive into this one, folks. I think we'll dive into this one and see what we can do. Hopefully cause enough damage without taking too much ourselves. We have the Mad Bombardiers and the Descending Suns. Hopefully the battlefield is in our favor. We have a fair bit of artillery as well. So, yeah. To the battlefield we go. Alright, folks. Let's see what we can do. Not the biggest fan of this battlefield, I'll be honest with you. Don't like some of the shapes we're seeing. They've got the high ground. They'll probably stay back there because they have artillery as well somewhere back here, right? So that's going to be a bit of a problem. Fortunately, Ulrich is up in the air. Yeah, he is. So he could go in there and perhaps cause some trouble for their artillery and prevent it from firing away. While up front, we can have our Outriders as well as our Mad Bombardiers and Descending Suns causing some trouble. Let's get these guys grouped up and in guard mode. Get some shots in on these Forsaken, perhaps. The Marauders as well. Like, a good spread there that we can hit. And meanwhile, see, this is where the trouble is. How can I get clean shots with our artillery from down here? I don't want to push them up there because that's scary. Not only is there a building blocking their shots, but it's also a really kind of an exposed position. Okay, here's what we'll do. Let's get the spears on either end. Actually, let's do the giants on this side, so let's do this. Let's do this. Like so. And then get these guys lined up. Cool. Ah, again, they have artillery, so I kind of want to be thinned out and not packed, but at the same time, I was hoping to position my Hammer of the Witches, like, over here or something. Can they get shots in from there? Oh, okay, they can. The range is greater than I realized, I guess. Let's maybe nudge them over even a bit further. Yeah, okay, we might be able to get some shots in as they move towards us. I just don't know if they'll be able to fire over this little hill. That's the thing. We'll see. Only one way to find out, I suppose, right? We'll see. Okay, that's that. These guys can come down over here, meanwhile. Because, again, they can fire over the, over allied troops. Go ahead and rotate them so they don't have to rotate after the battle begins. There you go. Cool. Get these guys both grouped up. Guard mode for you too. And let's, of course, get all of our ranged units grouped up. Guard mode. Tighten them up like this. And then spread them out because there's artillery on the other side of the battlefield. Very scary artillery too. Let's do this, and that way, like, when the... when the giant comes through or something, we just gotta focus fire. This is actually gonna be a pretty rough battle. I gotta stay on top of this one because we can actually take a lot of damage if I'm careless. Let's get you grouped up on the topic of being careless, and let's begin the fight. Move you up. These guys already being hit by a Spirit Leech, it looks like. And a bombardment. My goodness. Such a very... I love the new graphic for the Spirit Leech, by the way. Okay, in come some shots over here. The Forsaken is Siege taking a decent bit of damage there. The Marauders, too. Artillery fire coming through as well. And I see their Hell Cannon there. Let's go ahead and dive on in nice and early and pull these guys back. Looks like the Chaos Knights of Zinch are coming through with their lances. Pull back. If I can just get them into range of our... ranged units, right? Oh my goodness. In comes a hit from the Hell Cannon. That is a lot of damage from just one hit. That's ridiculous. Turn around, hit these Marauders up over here. How are we looking? Pegasus is diving into the Hell Cannon. Good stuff. Gotta keep an eye on that. We're turning around and firing away over here. Hopefully doing it. Oh, that is a lot of damage on these Marauders. Good stuff, good stuff. Get the artillery firing away at them as well. Gotta get ready to pull back very quickly. Archers are able to fire away at some of these Forsaken of Slaanesh, it looks like. Archers, crossbow, I mean ranged units. The Hell Cannon is being kept busy back over there. That's excellent. Good stuff, good stuff. Turn around and fire away again at these Marauders quickly now as the ranged units are firing away as well. Let's go ahead and try and hit some of these Marauder horsemen. In come some shots. Oh god, it's getting real busy here now, isn't it? It's getting real busy over here. Let's pull back, let's pull back. Gotta be careful about those Warhounds as well. In comes a bombardment. Let's try and dodge that as best as we can. Yeah, good shooting on these Marauder horsemen. That's great. And where is their giant? I don't see. Oh, there it is, all the way at the back. Good stuff. The Hell Cannon is being taken care of. Excellent. The Warhounds over there not liking that. Let's go ahead and send these spears over to try and intercept them and protect our artillery. Fire up over there, please. Go ahead and fire up over there. Archers are doing a lot of work against Archaon, hopefully. You know what? Actually, they're not. Hit the giant instead. Drop the giant. Well, Hell Cannon's almost taken care of. Again, it's unbreakable, right? So it's a bit of trouble. In comes their Chaos Knights. Oh my goodness. Let's go ahead and get some charges in. Try and shut down those Marauder Horsemen. Push these guys in against the spawn. Spears are holding. Archers are firing away. Crossbows are firing away. Good stuff. Spears are holding over here as well against the Warhounds. That's good. These Warhounds are going to come in from behind us, aren't they? Get these swords coming in over here. Get all of these cavalry units moving up, firing into the backs of these clumps, perhaps. Get away, get away. Okay, these Warhounds are going to have a field day against our archers. But looks like Ulrich over there is done. Let's go ahead and pull them back. And maybe deal with Archaon. Oh my god. Okay. Okay, we're okay. We're okay. Send these guys in with some rear charges, perhaps. Or actually send them in against these Warhounds. Get you guys firing into these Marauder Horsemen. And looks like the Hammer of the Witches is able to fire. No, it's not. Let's move these guys away. Our artillery. Oh, we're in trouble. We're in trouble. We're in trouble. Fire away at this clump, please. Swords are coming through. Pull these crossbows up. Get you guys firing away at these Marauders, perhaps. Some of these guys need to return. Come on. Outriders are firing away in here. Where are my mad bombardiers and stuff? They've been terrified off. Are you for real? These spawn of Slaanesh caused some damage there, eh? And our Chaon's causing some trouble, too. Ulrich is in here. Good stuff. Get these guys firing away. Come on now. Come on now. Come on. Big clumps. Big clumps over here. Hammer the Witch is giving up on the fight. These guys are about to get hit by a bombardment. Come on. Dodge that. We're kind of okay. In comes the spawn of Slaanesh, though. Less okay now. Ulrich, how you doing? You doing okay? Sigmar's sons over here not having a good time. Oh, they've really pushed in, haven't they? They've really pushed in. Turn these guys around. Chaos Troll's causing us some trouble as well. Pull these guys back. Outriders still firing away. I mean, we're doing well over here in this clump, but everywhere else we're in a bit of trouble. These guys to fire away at these Hellstriders. Let's get you back on your equipment. How are we looking over here? Okay, good stuff, good stuff. Into the Chaos Trolls over here. Get you firing away. I mean, Archaon took like no damage, eh? Let's finish these Chaos Spawn off, please. Send these guys in as well. Let's go. Oh, man. There's Warhounds back here. That's trouble. Pull these guys up. In comes a charge from these Marauder Horsemen. No, they've actually pulled back at the last minute. Interesting choice there. Ulrich is doing okay-ish, I suppose. Help as much as we can, however we can. Fire away these Chosen, I suppose. Oh, get you out of there, buddies. Get you out of there. Let's go. Let's go. We're done over here. Let's push in. Send you in as well. Doing some damage against these Chosen of Khorne. Pull back. Get away from them. I've pushed in over here. Can we turn these guys around? Let's go. Hit these Warhounds, please. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Let's go, let's go. All right, cool. Hang in there, folks. Hang in there. We're getting some of them to break, finally. Oh, that bombardment's going to hurt, isn't it? Yep, that is bad. That is real bad. We might have actually lost this one. Pull back a bit more from here. Get out of there. Archaon just, like, has taken no damage. Get out of there, get out of there. If we can get army losses or something to trigger, we'll be in a better position. These guys come on firing in. Maybe hit up over here. You know, I think we might actually lose this battle. Despite all the work we did, we might actually lose this battle. Got a few of these units to break. That's good, but Ulrich looks like he's about to break, actually. These guys have given up on the fight. Yeah, these guys have been engaged in melee. Oh my goodness. Get up in the air, buddy. Come on, get up in the air. Let's go, let's go. Up in the air, I said. Alright, still causing some damage over here. Hitting some of these marauders. There we go, Ulrich's finally up. Get these guys to turn around and fire away over here, perhaps. Get to work. Ulrich, what to do here? Let's hit some of these marauders up there. Get these guys moving. Spears down over here. Ascending Suns over here. Sure. Oh, no. Hammer of the Witches is leaving. Okay, they've not been destroyed. They're leaving. Get these guys out of here. Move, let's move. I wonder how much damage Friendly Fire actually did today. I wonder how much damage was done by Friendly Fire. These guys are terrified. Let's go ahead and hit some of these marauders down over here as well. Turn you around. Oh, that's not good. That's not good. Oh, they've been terrified. Come on, tell me we can turn this around. Tell me we can turn this around. Break these Chosen of Khorne. Eliminate these spawn of Nurgle as well. Okay, hitting some of these Chosen. Alright, Ulrich's coming through over here as well now. About to dive into these Marauder Horsemen, or these Marauders perhaps. Cause a bit of morale damage. Don't know how much that's going to help us here. Can I hit anything without getting Archaon involved? Man, these Chosen really sticking around, eh? They're not giving up on the fight. Let's try and hit some of these Spawn of Nurgle, I suppose. Ulrich, might need to pull you out again, buddy. I thought I would break these guys with that charge, but I guess not. I think that's it. Ulrich himself has given up. I think that's it. Come on, stand and fight, men. Stand and fight. Or surrender. A valiant defeat. You know what? Wow. That's three battles in a row that we've suffered defeats. That's rough. I mean, the army survived, obviously. We were the attacker. We were able to pull back. We lost Sigmar's Sons, but otherwise, I think all the other units are still alive, but in a very precarious spot. Azazel is right there. How did Archaon's army cause so much damage? God damn. We shut that Hell Cannon down, like, right away. Those Warhounds did a lot of work. Those Warhounds did a lot of work, and you know what? These Chaos Knights as well. 136 kills, are you kidding me? And of course, Archaon himself, 154. Is this Vlad 2.0? Where it's just like impossible? My goodness, we outnumbered them 2-1, give or take. They did not care. That is terrifying. That is terrifying. I thought I had that in the bag. We've caused a fair bit of damage to this army, though. I wouldn't be surprised if, yes, quite a few of their units have been completely eliminated. We took down the Giant. We took down the Spawn. We took down, well, both units of Spawn. We got the Hell Cannon. Yeah. Hellstriders, Marauders, Forsaken. Cool. And everybody else also, we did a fair bit of damage there. We lost Sigmar's Sons, as can be expected, of course. They are unbreakable, right? So they're very likely to die that way. Oh, we lost the White Wolves as well. That's unfortunate. It's okay. You know, I'm genuinely not all that upset about that, because they weren't my favorite unit to have in here. They were recruited in a moment of desperation. So that's actually not the end of the world. But yikes. Big yikes. How far back did we pull? Close to Erengrad. I wonder. Watch the quarry. I wonder. So Archaon is very unlikely, I think, to strike at us now. With a 13 stack so badly damaged, I doubt he's going to make a move. Azazel is obviously poised for a strike at Erengrad. Can I take this army on with just Ubel in his current state? I mean, again, some of these units are not at full strength, especially our cavalry, right? Our cavalry in particular is a little worrying. The Sunmaker as well, not at full strength, missing an actual piece of equipment. I'm wondering if I swap Ulrich into Erengrad, send Ubel after Azazel, and meet him out in the open field. And even if we suffer another defeat, at least we'll push them back. Up over here, meanwhile, don't tell me, are you for real? Well, yeah, what is this foolishness? We got two near full stacks heading down south over here as well. Why me? I mean, I know why, because I'm the player and that's how these games are made. Oh my. I think we're in a bit of trouble, folks. I think we're in a bit of trouble. Down over here, meanwhile, again, we're still making our moves towards Azag's army there and to taking back Khazad Irkalaz. I wonder if this is a fool's errand here. Sending Nicholas to Arnau. Let's see. Two settlements. So they do only have these two settlements. He's come all this way. I think I'd be more of a fool to not conclude the mission. Up to R now we go. Declare this war in the midst of all these other wars. Let's go for it. Yep, good stuff, good stuff. They do have an army in there, but I don't think that's going to be a concern for us. Decisive victory, low casualties. Go ahead and auto-resolve this. Thank you very much. Didn't take too much damage. Did a lot of damage, though. Good stuff, good stuff, good stuff. Go ahead and occupy this, because, of course, we want to try and maintain the wasteland as best as possible, right? We want to improve it. We want to upgrade it. We want to, among all other things, secure it and get extra income from all buildings, right? That'll help tremendously. And it looks like R now, actually, I'm glad I just occupied it because it has a clothier that helps our economy a fair bit as well. Now, how much damage did we take there? Not too much, so that's good. Let's go ahead and see if we can't get Benediction now. Excellent. And we'll hit Wrecker's Point next turn, I suppose. Burn it down to the ground. I have no interest in keeping it. Over here, Greebitz's army is not really a threat. In fact, I would invite them to strike at us because then I don't have to chase after them to finish them off. That would be ideal. And otherwise, yeah, the big situation remains up and around Erengrad. This endless tide of chaos in all its forms is going to take some time to take care of, folks. It's not going to get done today, though, because this is what we're calling it. A bit of a cliffhanger situation, I think. We're in dire straits. This is terrifying. I'm really excited to see how next session plays out. I hope you are as well. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, you know what to do. Let me know by leaving a like and a comment down below. As always, it makes a very big difference. And just letting me know what y'all are interested and just enjoying on the channel. What I should keep doing, what I should slow down, speed up. Y'all have heard me say it countless times now. As always, as well, of course, a massive thanks goes out to all of the channel members and patrons who've been supporting the channel on a monthly basis. Y'all keep us alive and running smoothly. And of course, a big old thanks goes out to each and every one of you for watching. Until next time. Cheers.